Interest rates could go up, not down, before the next federal election.
To discuss, let's bring in John Keogh, economics editor of the Australian Financial Review. Johnny, good morning. What are the financial markets betting? Is the outlook for the Reserve Bank?
Yes, happy Friday, Carl and Sarah. Look, there's been a big change in the outlook for interest rates in recent days amongst professional investors who bet on the future direction of rates. Now they're pricing in about a 50% chance of a rate rise late this year. And not only that, they're saying there won't be a rate cut until around about May or June next year. And that's potentially after a federal election, which is due by May. And so not only big ramifications for households, but potentially politics as well.
See, it's been a seismic shift in 2 weeks, has it not?
Yeah, it has. And we've seen it happening in the US as well. Carl, the US Federal Reserve Chairman yesterday, Jerome Powell, saying that rate cuts were on hold. At the start of the year, they were penciling in 6 rate cuts, the US Federal Reserve. And that has all sorts of knock-on effects for Australia because we don't exactly copy what they do, but we certainly influence what they do. And a lot of these inflation pressures that we're seeing around the world are happening not just in Australia, but other places as well.
All right. Just so you know, I've taken West Coast against the Bombers this weekend.
Oh, Harley Reid's back.
Harley's back, mate. You're finished.
Yeah, Harley Reid, he's a brilliant player. I'm a bit nervous about him jumping back in, Carl. But I reckon the Bombers will get the job done. And look, for the Essendon and West Coast fans who remember back to the 1990s, I hope we get the Kevin Sheedy red and black scarf wave going after the game.
Jesus, that's really throwing it back there, Johnny.
You've got to go back to the good days. Thank you, Johnny.